Hello everyone, today we are going to speak about zero-touch provisioning. Majorly we are going to take an example of Cisco's SD-WAN, how a box when it is going to a branch location and how a branch is getting up within just a fraction of time and with zero effort. I mean, all those things which were one of the challenges in traditional way when we used to wrap up a router or switch or any devices which need to be sent, how the overall cumbersome process used to take place and the time used to be taken. So that is the power of ZTP, which has been given as a better or a differentiator USP as a part of evaluation of software defined by data network. So this is in continuation of my previous video where we have seen what all the challenges industry is facing with respect to traditional wide area network and what those challenges and how those challenges are being getting solved or getting benefited with the evaluation of software defined wide area network. So this video is we are going to majorly focus on zero touch provisioning process, how the data flow happen with taking an example of Cisco's SD-WAN as an technology, and along with a wrap up of how the thing happened, I mean on a live demo with some basic scenario of how the branch used to take a policy or how it happens just in a fraction of a second, like a boom. Okay, so rather wasting time, so in continuation I'll just kick off with ZTP. Yep. So zero touch provisioning is one of the USP or the use case for software defined wide area network. Why you have taken a Cisco SD-WAN? Just Cisco's being leading market vendor and their prominent technology, how things happen with Cisco's SD-WAN, that is what I'm going to show you as a demo. So before ZTP, what exactly or how much effort do you want you normally use to put to make a branch, any branch live, right? So normally what happens is you whenever a device or whenever you place an order, right, any device comes to your centralized data center staging area where you need to unwrap the device, then you need to do some bare minimum configuration, lot of man efforts, unloading of bay, I mean it's in heavy trucks rolling across the data center, and it's, you know, and then getting a pre-configuration, at least a bare minimum zero configuration, show that you need to have some sort of connectivity when you plug onto the branch location, right? And you always require a transport availability at the branch office. Even before the device is shipped to your branch location, we always go and require a dependency of any transport availability like MPLS, and you need to do the testing of the MPLS for the link availability or link performance or stability, reliability, all those things required. I mean majorly is that the availability of the transport so that you can have the complete testing or the connectivity at least to the box when it is being connected and plugged with the cable on the branch location with whatever the pre-configuration you have done on the step one, right? A lot of coordination work, right? It's a process. The box is shipped and unshipped, then done the pre-configuration, and then again it has been packed and it sends to branch location along with the coordination at the branch location, some guy who is required to unpack and unbox it and again rack and stack and do the cabling work for all those boxes. A lot of coordination work, and you need to plan it with a lot of dependencies of each and every player or the member who has to be required to make a branch up, right? The final and the most of the critical thing, you need a skilled engineer at the branch location. So when the boxes arrive at the branch, someone has to understand what configuration or any troubleshooting required to be done on the box in case of any issue, or you need to plug onto the right cable, you need to do a configuration what your central NOC team used to say that, oh okay, just do the configuration on this box, or take this configuration on your laptop, do a console of it and do all those configuration, all those things, right? Maybe a bare minimum configuration just for a connectivity, and again if the console or connectivity goes down, then engineer required to troubleshoot by taking the knock on the call. So all these four parameter makes the overall process almost to take of 2 to 4 weeks or even a month to make a branch live. Consider that if any retail or CPG or any banking or ATM or anything, any other enterprise customer in any different sectors wants to make a branch in live in 1 or 2 days, so will this process will work? No. So you need to plan it. So a hell lot of planning is required to, when we go as a manual process on a step by step, right? So that is where the power of software defined wide area network comes, as one of the use case called zero touch provisioning. So what in this particular slide, we are just going to see how the overall data flow happens with Cisco's SD-WAN box. I mean, the overall process or the traffic flow happens when a box is shipped directly to your branch location. So let's see how things happens. Their data traffic or their data plane traffic is controlled by a device called Cisco VH device. It's just a small 1U or 2U maximum router. And you should have just a transport medium of internet connectivity. It could be 4G dongle, it could be ADSL or DSL, just an Ethernet handoff, so that you can have connectivity to their viptela zero touch provisioning server, which is in the internet, directly from the branch. So what is there when a device actually land onto the branch location with a factory default configuration of VBOND IP address as ztp.viptela.com? So once you plug the internet cable onto that Ethernet port of GE0/0, it queries to that particular ztp.viptela.com, which is their internet ZTP server placed on their viptela cloud. Once the traffic lands onto that particular cloud, it actually authenticates that particular box and sees that this particular device or the serial number, it actually responds to that particular edge device with the enterprise orchestrator or the enterprise VBOND IP address to that particular VH device. So the response from the viptela cloud or the ZTP server comes to redirect to its original enterprise VBOND IP address. Then the packet from the VH device goes to the enterprise orchestrator VBOND as a actual communication. So how things happen here is then the VBOND IP address, whatever the IP address given from ZTP server, then it goes for initial communication. There happens the control plane communication authentication between the VH and the VBOND. So it is basically on DTLS or TLS based certificate based authentication, where enterprise VBOND IP address authorized the device based on this authenticity of the organization name or the serial number, whatever has been configured on the VH or VManaged devices or the VBOND. So once that has been done, then VBOND sends the vSmart controller or the vManage IP address to the VH devices based on the complete authentication. So those particular IP address, all the control component and of the viptela for the enterprise customer for this particular VH also forms a control plane communication based on the standard process with the certificate based authentication, DTLS or DLS control plane channels happens. Once that has been done, then vManage pushes the initial device configuration, that is what exactly the interface IP address will be, or what would be the local LAN IP address, and which VR of it, or I mean which VPN it should be, what are the service VPN, what are the management IP address, all those things will be pushed onto this particular devices from vManage. Once that has been done, then the policy or the template which is required for data plane communication is been pushed from vManage to vSmart, and then vSmart to your VH devices as a full registration and configuration process. So if you see the overall process, it's just a matter of just power on the device, plug the internet connectivity for the stuff, and a person who understand, and you can just guide the person not to console it, just to plug the right cable onto the right port, the branch is up. That is the power of zero touch provisioning with the evolution of software defined by DDN network. So this is one of the POC or the use cases which normally been given to all the enterprise customer, so that the branch is actually live, not for a month or weeks or 21 days, whatever the standard process, just within a day. And also you can do the testing once that branch is up, right? With this, we will go for a demo how the things happen on live in our lab environment. So this is the topology what we are going to see. So this particular branch edge is configured with nothing. It has nothing configuration, so it just have a connectivity with GE0 as one of the internet connectivity, which is on a shutdown phase, and having no configuration in this. So you can just see that how the traffic happens, and it actually goes to VBOND and all the configuration it takes without any intervention of any skilled SME. Okay, with rather not wasting time, let me just jump on to my lab console. Let me just go there. Okay. Yeah. So let me just, yeah, so this is the one. So if you see this, there is no configuration, no control connections, no data sessions and interface description. You just see there's no configuration on G02 or LAN. It's just system IP, just because it's an demo, I mean lab setup, so we just need a configuration for the management interface. Yeah, so nothing is there, and the host name is also, you can say, just VH, no configuration. It's just a bare minimum configuration because of the demo setup. We have just no configuration. So you can see just management interface and VPN 0 or the G intro, which is an internet connectivity, we have put it shut down. So we are just going to simulate how things happen. Okay, so I'll just log on to vManage device. If you see vManage, I have 7 VH devices, out of which 6 is live and 1 is down. So that is what the branch which we are going to simulate for zero touch provisioning. So we have some standard templates of what is required. So this is the branch 2 template, what has been configured. I'll just show you what is there on this particular template. So this particular template has a configuration, a standard VPN and the 2 interface for internet and MPLS and the management interface for stuff. Everything is standard, nothing to worry, no majors. And you have a data plane for VPN 10 with OSPF as a bare minimum configuration and the interface IP address which is required. Okay, so you can just cancel it and I'll just go, and you just need to do simple click. VManage is already been accessible, so you just need to do attach a device. So you need to be very sure that, because we already have this particular configuration where we have changed the name to BRVH or BR2VH1 branch 2. So you need to map the serial number whenever it is a new device. The serial number has to be accurate so that the exact serial number is getting that particular template. So you just select that device and it will come onto the selected device pane and just set attach. So once you attach, the second window comes about what exactly the configuration is going to be on this particular device. So it says that the system IP is this, this is the chassis number, and we are going to push that template branch type 2, and what exactly is going to be in this particular template. So because these are the things which require manual configuration effort, so which I have already done it. So it is actually says that this will be the host name, all this latitude, longitude, this will be the system IP address and the branch site ID, along with the MPLS gateway IP address, interfaces, and basic all the interface bare minimum configuration with your VPN or management interface IP address, all those things, right? So we just update it and we go for next. You just need to select the chassis and configure the device. So you can see that it's in progress. So vManage is now pushing the bare minimum template onto the box. Okay, validation success. But if you see on the box what is happening now, you're just checking and creating the message. So it just selected the template and sets the site ID and vManage IP address, whatever it's required. Let's see on this what is happening here. So we see the interface description. No, nothing has happened. Let's see what is happening here. So let's wait, it still goes on in progress. So it's just the thing that the template is trying to push onto that particular device. It will be pushed once the device comes up into the internet. Okay, so let's wait. What is happening? So if you see, this still the device is showing down. So if you just click on the down arrow, it will be prompted to your directly. It says unreachable. So let's troubleshoot. And there is no connections of BFDs and OMP also, it's not there, right? And it's a VH device, so which is the bare minimum also. Okay, so because it's a ZTP concept what we are trying to simulate here, so as I said that in VPN 0, if you see the showrun, right, if you see the showrun, what we have trying to simulate is the VPN interface G0/1 is shut down, which is an interface of internet. So we just need to enable that interface. It is as if like you are just plugging an Ethernet interface onto VPN0 interface. All this configuration was already shown on the template, so don't worry about that. It's just a simulation, so we have done this already. So if bare minimum box when comes, you just plug the cable onto G0/1, whatever the template you have configured. You just need to plug either it's G0/0 or 0/1. Okay, so let's unshut this and let's see what happens. 0/1, no shut. Okay, and make sure you need to commit. So it's just like write on Cisco routers. Okay, so now you see what happens. So it is as if like the interface, internet interface gone up. Now it actually connect to the vbound IP address. See, now you can see the interface got a transport DHCP IP address from the internet service provider. Boom, bang. The device got a host name automatically from vmanage because the policy was already pushed. It was just polling. Once the device connected to the vbound and it actually connected to the vmanage, all the required configuration has been applied onto the box without any user intervention. That's the beauty of zero touch provisioning. See the control connections relevant up. So you can see that it has a TTLS connection which is up via the internet with your vSmart controller. vSmart controller, another one, DTLS again, which is via MPLS, right? Another one, the DTLS connection with vManage, again a DTLS control secure connection via internet. That's the beauty. Let's see the IPsec connection, that is the BFD sessions with other branches. Beautiful. So you can see that a lot of connection with DC1 or DC2, because all those sites are there in the topology, which I just show on DC here. So everything is there. So that is the power of zero touch provisioning, where you don't require any manual intervention, right? And it's just the thing that how things happen. It just enable this internet facing interface, and all the template which was there configured on our vManage is pushed automatically. The right cable was placed on the right interface of the box, that and it is ready, and the branch is ready to serve for user data traffic with controlled policies what have been pushed from the centralized management stuff. So with this, I'll just end up this video, and I would like to thank you, and I hope this session was informative, and please keep watching and subscribe the video for more talks, so that it's always helped me to publish more and more videos with respect to SD-WAN or SDN or SDA, anything you want, we can discuss more. I'll try to add more and more. Thanks for the time and thanks for watching. Thank you very much.